Let's start with question number 1 of exercise 4.2. So it says find the roots of the following quadratic equations by factorization. So as you know, the general equation for quadratic equation is ax square plus bx plus c equals 0. Now we have to take a and c and multiply them. So in this case, my a is 1 and c is 10. So the product of a and c will be 10. Now we have to take factors of 10 such that they should divide 3x into equal parts. So basically we have to split the middle term here. We have to split bx here such that they should form the same number. So I will split it into 2 and 5. Why? Because minus 5 plus 2 makes minus 3x. So it will be x square minus 5x plus 2x minus 10 equals 0. Now from the first two terms we can take x common, so we are left with x and minus 5. Then in the second one we can take 2 common, so we are left with x then minus 5 equals 0. So we have two roots, that is x minus 5 and another is x plus 2. So we have to equate them to 0. So the first root will be x equals 5 and the second will be x equal minus 2. Now moving on to the second part, it says 2x square plus x minus 6 equals 0. So we have to again split the middle term. So again we would be taking the product of a and c. So it is 12, 6 into 2 is 12. We have to factorize such that it makes x. So in this case we can take 4x minus 3x, because 4 and 3 are the factors of 12. So it will be 2x square plus 4x minus 3x minus 6 equals 0. Now from the first two terms we can take common 2x and we are left with x and 2, x plus 2. In the second two, we can take 3 common minus 3 common. So we are left with minus 3 and x plus 2. So we have x plus 2 as factor and 2x minus 3 as factor. Again, you have to equate both of them to 0. So from first, we have x equals minus 2. From second, we have 3 over 2. So these are two roots for second number. Then moving on to the third part. Third part says under root 2 x square plus 7x plus 5 under root 2 equals 0. Now as you know, we have to multiply this and this, a and c basically. So it will be 10. So we have to make factors of 10 according to the question. It is 7x. So we can take 5 and 2. So I will write it as 2x plus 5x. So under root 2x square plus 2x plus 5x plus 5 under root 2 equals 0. Now you can take x common from first 2 and under root 2 common from first 2. So under root 2x common, x we are left with, then under root 2. Now we have to take 5 common from the last two terms. It will be 5x plus under root 2 whole square. So we have two roots now, that is x plus under root 2 and another is under root 2x plus 5. Again we have to equate them to 0. So my roots will be x equal minus under root 2, and for the other one it will be minus 5 under root 2. Now moving on to fourth part. So this is my fourth part. Here we have to take LCM of 8 first of all. So the first term will be 16x square minus 8x then plus 1 equals 0. Now I will take 8 to the right hand side. So 0 times 8 will be 0. Then we are left with 16x square minus 8x plus 1 equals 0. So we have a, we have c. So a and c is 16. So we have to make factors of 16. So it will be 4x and 4x. So 16x square minus 4x minus 4x plus 1 equals 0. Then we can take common from first two terms, that is 4x. And we are left with 4x, then minus 1. Now in the second one, in the last two terms, we have to take minus 1 common. So it will be 4x minus 1, 0. So therefore we have 4x minus 1 as a factor. So x will be 1 over 4. And in the second case, again 1 over 4. Now the fifth part says 100x square minus 20x plus 1 equals 0. So in this case, again we have to take 100 and 1. So 100 times 1 is 100. So we have to make factors of 100 such that they make 20. So 100 can be written as 50 into 2, or you can write it as 10 into 10. So 10 into 10 can be a good factor for 20. So we can write it as 100x square minus 10x minus 10x plus 1 equals 0. So we can take common 10 and x from first two terms. So it will be 10x minus 1. Then in this last two terms, we can take only minus 1 so that it would be a same factor. Now we have two factors, that is 10x minus 1 and 10x minus 1. So it will be x 1 over 10, x 1 over 10. So these are the two factors for the fifth one. So that's the last part of question number 1.